The jam-packed festive football season is upon us. The Premier League is ploughing on amid a rise in COVID cases, and even though Liverpool, Leeds, Watford, Everton, Burnley and Wolves now won't feature, it promises to be a thrilling Boxing Day. Manchester United and Newcastle have an extra day before returning to action, but all the other top-flight teams' clubs will take to the field to give fans 7 hours of wall-to-wall football. The jam-packed festive football season is upon us. The Premier League is ploughing on amid a rise in COVID cases, and even though Liverpool, Leeds, Watford, Everton, Burnley and Wolves now won't feature, it promises to be a thrilling Boxing Day. Manchester United and Newcastle have an extra day before returning to action, but all the other top-flight teams' clubs will take to the field to give fans 7 hours of wall-to-wall football. One, Spurs will want revenge against an old foe. Patrick Vieira faced his old rivals Tottenham for the first time since his Arsenal days in September, and what a reunion it was for the former midfielder. He guided his Crystal Palace side to a resounding 3-0 victory over Spurs in what was a torrid display by Nuno Espirito Santo's side. Vieira proved to be a thorn in Spurs' side for years and silenced them once more in the Selhurst Park encounter. Tottenham will want revenge, and they are an entirely different proposition under Antonio Conte, compared to the team that was turned over 3 months ago. They put in an excellent performance against Liverpool last week and reached the semi-finals of the Carabao Cup in midweek. 2. Arsenal can cement a top four spot. The Gunners are gathering momentum as their youngsters continue to step up and shoulder the responsibility under Mikel Arteta. Their abysmal start seems a distant memory as Thieve found form and moved up into fourth position. Thieve registered 3 league wins on the bounce, and they can cement their place in the Champions League spots against relegation-threatened Norwich. Arteta's side are currently 4 points ahead of West Ham, although they have a game in hand, and 6 points off third-placed Chelsea. The young boss isn't afraid to make bold calls, indicated by his decision to take the captaincy from Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, and his methods finally seem to be bearing fruit on the pitch.